Now we're going to deal with a microscope or telephoto lens, any system where there are two thin lenses now. And we did a problem issue a few videos ago where we had the two convex lenses a distance apart from each other. And we used the fact that you first just look at the one first lens, it creates an image, and that image becomes the object for the second lens. And we have the two equations there, the magnification and total of these two of the two lenses, this magnification of the first lens times the magnification of the second lens, but then there you see another equation. And in different textbooks they will look different. What that boils down to is the fact that you are going to have your first lens, and this is called, if you have your little amoeba that you're looking at there, this is called F1, or the objective lens. And you're usually going to place, it will have a focal point, a focal distance, and you're going to place your object round about in the focal distance. This is going to create for you a real image that is inverted, and this real inverted image is then going to be the object of the second image. So, and that is just now going to be your object image, and this is going to create for you, again inverted, but now it's going to be upright, a second image. So, how do we get, what does this equation mean? Dn is just the mere point, which we're going to take as a positive 25 centimeters, or is positive 25 centimeters, divided by F2, which is the focal distance of this lens, F2, which most textbooks call Fe for the eyepiece lens, because your eye is going to go there. Okay, plus one. And then that SI is important. That SI refers to this first lens's image distance, okay? Divided by the focal length of this first lens, minus one. In the next video, let's look at a problem. Okay, as promised here, a problem. I have my compound microscope. Compound meaning there's these two lenses. My objective lens has a focal distance of positive 0.8. My eyepiece lens 2.5. I'm holding my eye close to the eyepiece lens. In other words, what do I want to see? Well, I want to see a comfortable image magnified a lot, but still at a comfortable near point of 25 centimeters. And that is where we have this SI double prime. It must be at 25 centimeters. But the only thing that we are told is that this first lens has an image of distance of positive 16 centimeters is going to be a real image. With that positive focal lens, we know that this is going to be an inverted image. We just want to know what the magnification is going to be at this comfortable 25 centimeter near point image that I am going to see. Now, we can go about this in two ways. I'm going to show you that the first way is easy with the equation, because we already have everything we need. The second way is probably more proper, and there's a slight trick to it, and I'll show you. Okay, so we're going to have magnification is going to equal dn is this 25 centimeters. So there's not a, I don't put a negative there, even though it's going to be on the other side of the lens. Dn is near point, is 25. F2 for me is going to be 2.5, and I'm going to have centimeters, and I'm going to have negative 1, and then I'm going to have. Now the first objective lens forms its image at 16, divided by its focal length, which is, have I got that one? Its focal length is 0.8, that's plus 1, sorry, and negative 1. And that gives me an answer of about 209. 209 is going to be the magnification, and that's a positive 209. Let's go about this though, wherein we look at the two lenses separately. The first lens, I've got to see what the objective distance is, because I'm going to use this equation. So first I need the magnification for that. And for that magnification, I need minus SI divided by SE0. I do have SI, but I don't have S0. I can very quickly get it, inasmuch as 1 over S0 is going to be 1 over F minus 1 over SI. That gives me an SO of, let me see, that gives me an SO of 16 over 19, just check on your calculator, 16 over 19 meters. And if I plug that in there, it's going to be 16 divided by 16 over 19, but a negative, and that is going to give me a negative 19 magnification. So this image is inverted. Now please remember that, because I have my first, now this is not to scale, I have my object there, this one is going to be there, negative. Okay, so when the second lens sees this one, okay, obviously it's going to be what we want, what we're going to have in this instance is we want 25 centimeters away from there, we want this virtual upright image. Now let's just look at that. Now what we were not told is this length L between these two lenses. We know though now that say for instance we do have these two, this distance between them is L, but this distance from here to there say is 16 centimeters, which is probably then going to be beyond this. So what we're looking at, and this image is probably not going to form there, but say for instance somewhere there. Now this distance here then between this lens and our object is going to be 16 minus L, but it's on the negative side, so I have to put a negative there. That gives me L minus 16 for my new SO. My new SO, SO prime, is going to be L minus 16. Okay, so let's just see where this image ends up. So we're going to have 1 over L minus 16, because 1 over SI has got to be, for my second lens, 1 over 2.5. That gives me an SI. What did I get for my SI? Let's just see. Not for SI. Remember, I know what SI is. I want this SI to be I want this to be a negative 25. Why am I putting negative 25 in there? Because I know I want a virtual image. Look at this carefully. This is going to be a negative number because it is beyond this lens, okay? But if that is negative, it means it would be the same as a positive on this side. But I want a virtual image on this side of 25. So my object in reality and my image on the same side, that's going to give me a virtual image, so that's got to be negative 25. That gives me an L value of 201 over 11, if you do that. And so, for instance, then I can work out my S0I, which is going to be 201 over 11 minus 16, which gives me an L value of that. And that gives me an S0 of, let me see, what did I get? 25 over 11. 25 over 11. Just check on your calculator if that's correct. Now that I have my SI and I have my S0, I can just look at M. And that has got to be, negative SI. Here's my negative SI, which is the negative 25 divided by S0. And that is going to give me, I think that gives me an 11. That gives me an 11. So 19 times 11 also gives me 200. Do that, you'll also get 209. But now you see, it looks like we get a negative. But just remember, if we look at this straight on, if we just view it as if these were all correct, this was going to be a positive, this was going to be a negative, making this a positive. It's not really what happens in as much as I'm looking for virtual images. Okay, so the second magnification goes from a negative up to a positive. So this is actually also a negative in as much as it's going to be in the opposite direction. So multiplying these two gives me 209. So there's a lot of mental jumps that have to be made to sort out the problem in this fashion. And think about it for yourself, but you will also get to 209. Easier in this instance just to use the magnification of a compound microscope equation as we have up here.